Hey everyone! Last week I went to Pasadena, California, and I attended the Hackaday Superconfence. This was their 8th year, but it was my first year. Make It Hackin' was first in line, and he got a special SAO. This is just a picture of some of the tables they set up for badge hacking. They also had various breakout rooms to go to talks. They also had workshops, but I chose to spend my time hacking the badge. About 80 people participated in the SMD soldering challenge, soldering 1206 to 0201 components. I believe only one person was able to successfully get all 5 LEDs working. They also provided breakfast, lunch, and dinner. There were a ton of really cool add-ons, like these lights with names. There was also some SAO development boards, and even a digital multimeter in SAO format. This was amazing. We worked on getting our badge to talk to the Mac SAO, and I spent a ton of time getting this Etch-a-Sketch working. Here's a table with all the stuff I brought back from the conference, but let's take a closer look. Every attendee got one of these bags. They also got a t-shirt in whatever size, and a Hackaday Superconfence mug. You can see that cool logo with the 8th year on it. They also gave us this nice metal water bottle. It says Hackaday.io/Superconfence on the bottom there. Registration was only $320 US, so I was impressed with how much stuff they gave us. There was also people passing out various stickers. The conference was packed with things to do, but I chose to hack on the badge. This year's badge was a Raspberry Pi powered by 2 AA batteries. P10 through 16 are available, and there's a micro USB for programming. On the front were 6 SAO connections. 1 through 3 shared one I2C bus, and 4 through 6 shared another. And the GPIO 1 and 2 pins were all unique for each of the SAOs. Here are a few of the SAOs that they gave us. I'll go ahead and turn on the power. And you can see the pedal sequence on boot up. For the Supercon attended SAO, we had to solder on our own LEDs. All the resistors were already soldered. I chose to put the LEDs in backwards on the years that I didn't attend so that those lights were off. So the badge is running code that reads the thumb wheel and writes data to the pedal. So depending on what position we touch, we get a different result on the pedal. They also gave us 2 blank SAOs that were basically breakout boards. So I chose to connect an SK9822 LED string to that GPIO1 and GPIO2 plus power and ground on the breakout board. There was also an SAO with the CH32V003 that I haven't had a chance to look at yet, but hopefully I'll make something in the future. I think it should expose I2C and GPIO. Someone made this cool Hello My Name Is SAO where you can write your name and solder on an LED if you'd like. There's no data smarts, it's just pulling power and ground. I got one of these cool POV SAOs. It looks a lot better in person. It says Supercon 8. And in theory, you can use I2C to change the message, but I've been unsuccessful so far. In the future, I'll do a separate video on this SAO. It's an NFC name tag where you can choose what you want to be asked about. You can write your name, draw a cool little picture. There's NFC data that can be set or read through the phone or through the I2C interface. This next SAO exposed an accelerometer as well as 12 WS2812B LEDs. By default, the badge doesn't have any code to control these devices. There was this cool SAO demo controller, which has pins to both the SAO and the badge, and you could write your own firmware on here, and then have it control the SAO. Unfortunately, the software for the SAO demo controller is currently running what's needed for the Etch-a-Sketch. This SAO still needs me to solder on a microchip as well as some header pins and then connect it to an oscilloscope. Here's a picture from the Hackaday website showing the final result. Notice it's drawing that really cool logo on the oscilloscope. The next SAO is Skull of Fate from Pixel Thief and Make It Hackin. This SAO is loaded with different features. I'll go ahead and turn it on. You can see those lights turning on and the eyes turning on. So what it does is it generates a tarot card whenever you press down on the two buttons. So those eyes glow bright and now it has a new tarot card. So we can take our mobile phone and read it, and there's our thing. Seven of Wands. In last week's video, I was talking about the Flipper Zero as a badge add-on tester. And it turns out Thomas made this amazing SAO debug tool that just fits into the GPIO pins. I jumped pins 3 and 5 so that the Flipper Zero can use the SPI protocol as well. So here we have that SAO, the blinky loop that has the WS2812Bs and the accelerometer. And as I lift it up, you can see that we spin the lights faster. On the Flipper Zero screen, you can see the accelerometer data as we change the angle of the accelerometer. I also wrote an app for the badge tag NFC. It finds the device, writes the URL in the JavaScript. In my case, I'm writing that YouTube Mr. Derek Jameson. On a second flipper, I'll go into NFC and then I'll choose read, and we'll go ahead and read that NFC tag. And there it is. And you can see the UID 047517D269. And then on the top line here, you can see 047517. So those UIDs are correct. And if we go to info and choose more and scroll down, you can also see there's the YouTube channel with at Mr. Derek Jameson, just like it's showing there on those data channels. So pretty cool. We can read and write NFC data. Next up, we have the SAO touch wheel. And we're displaying the position 0 to 255 of where we're touching on the wheel. So you can see different values as I move along the wheel. And next, I wrote JavaScript for the SAO pedal. And so in this one, we find the device. We change that middle LED to different colors. And then we'll address all the LEDs individually. So this is using the I2C interface, and each string of lights is connected together, and we're just incrementing the bits that we send to those lights. And then this is the JavaScript I wrote for that SK9822 LEDs. And so these LEDs are connected via the four wires to our SAO add-on. The last thing I wanted to do was look at the code that's running on the badge that controls both that touch wheel and the pedal SAO. First, we'll install the application so that our computer can talk to the badge. I'm on Windows, so I'll choose Windows, and then I'll do the recommended for you option. Once it's downloaded, I'll go ahead and say open file and install for all users, but you can probably just do your single user. I'll just click next and install, take all the defaults. That'll take a minute to install, but once it's installed, go ahead and click finish. And then we're ready to just go ahead and run the app and click on let's go. I'll go ahead and maximize our window. And then I'll click on the bottom right. My badge is plugged into my computer and now it's showing up. It's showing up on COM4. And then under view, we'll say files. And there are the files from our badge. So it starts by loading boot.py and then it'll load main.py. Let's take a quick look at what's in that boot.py file. At the top of the file, we have our imports, and then we define the I2C addresses of our devices. And then we define the LED pin for output and turn it on. And then we define the three buttons on our badge as inputs with internal pull-up resistors. For our first SAO, we define our pins as output. We also set the pins for output on SAO 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. A funny story was I spent hours debugging why this Etch-a-Sketch on I2C wouldn't give me my knob positions. And it turned out all I needed to do was change GPIO 61 and 62 to be inputs. Because they were outputs, it was overriding the voltage I was reading from the knobs. The SAOs on the left side of the badge are connected to I2C0 and on the right side of the badge to I2C1. There's a function that takes the I2C address and returns back which bus is connected on that address. Different SAOs sometimes use same components, like the same screen. And so that SAO, one would have to be on the left side and one would have to be on the right side of the badge. Next, we initialize all the registers for the pedal. And this was super helpful. I copied all this code into my JavaScript that also controls the pedal. It tries initializing the pedal on the left bus and then again on the right bus. Here's some code that makes the pedal's middle LED turn yellow. And then here we're using I2C to read the register for where the touch wheel is being pressed. Here's the code that sets the RGB on the touch wheel. Next, I'll go ahead and open main.py. And here's the code that's doing that little spiral animation on startup. And then you can see the buttons on the badge control the color of the LED on the pedal. We read the value of the touch wheel, which we convert to a pedal index, and then we turn on that pedal, sending 7F instead of 00. We can click the green run button at the top of the screen, and it'll run the code on our badge. And you can see that I don't have a pedal plugged in, and I also don't have the touch wheel plugged in. I'll go ahead and connect those devices to my badge, and then we'll rerun the script. This time it detected the devices and it's sending that initialization sequence to the pedal. Thanks for watching this video. Please like and subscribe. And as I mentioned before, I focused on badge hacking, but there was a ton of other stuff going on at this conference. Let me know in the comments if you're planning on going to the conference next year.